Hello, everyone, and welcome to my ranking of the Ice Age movies. Yeah, having seen Ice Age 5 recently, I am, now here to do my ranking of the films. I'm going to be ranking all five of the movies in the series, so Ice Age, Ice Age 2, The Meltdown, Ice Age 3, Dawn of the Dinosaurs, Ice Age 4, Continental Drift, and Ice Age 5, Collision Course. So, let's get started. So, at number 5, which takes the pick as the worst of the series for me, is Ice Age 4, Continental Drift. This movie sucks. So bad. So bad. It's just terrible. I mean, the whole problem for me is that it's just too damn silly. I mean, the direction is just absolute cheeseball. The characters are, don't go on any journey. I mean, there's the whole thing with Manny being a father and that cliched stuff, and Peaches' subplot with trying to woo Ethan. Just awful. It's just a mess of a movie, and you know, there's way too many characters now in this film. You've got so many people in it as well, which doesn't help. Although, one thing it does have over some of the other films is the villain, Captain Gut. He happens to be quite good, but yeah, I don't know. There's not much you can say about Continental Drift. It's just a bore of a film. It's such a drag, and you just don't care about it, really. You just don't care. They make Diego a soft soap, make him too soft. There's some fun action scenes, there's a couple of laughs, and you can appreciate those. Sid's grandmother was annoying and forced. It does nothing for me. It just doesn't really do anything for me. It's the one I have the least amount of pleasure watching. It's the one that when I watch it, I get instantly bored, and I just can't watch it. It's just boring. Oh, and the stupid song in the credits, the We Are Family cover, I was like, what have you done to Ice Age? Like, I used to look forward to these films, but now, whenever there's a new one, you just have to look and go, oh, another one? Ice Age 3 should have been the ending. But no, let's drag it out for two more films. Ice Age 4, yeah, it's not great. Easily the worst. Terrible mess of a movie. Do not watch it. If you want my extensive thoughts, check out my review. Okay, so number 4 would have to be the most recent Ice Age movie, Ice Age 5, Collision Course. Now, I have to admit, I was a little bit surprised when I watched this film. Going into it, I was like, this isn't going to be great, but I'm not going to lie, I actually kind of thought it was alright. It's not anything amazing, but it's definitely a step up from the fourth one. It's definitely an improvement of the fourth one, but even then, again, it's silly. The ideas are still very silly. It's dumb, the asteroid falling, it's literally the bottom of the barrel. Couldn't think of any more ideas, so they went with this. These scratch scenes have been exhausted now. This is the film where you really start to feel the tedium of the scratch scenes. They have become such boring scenes. I mean, the scenes in space, I mean, you can get a couple of laughs, but even then it's not enough to really, it's the same concept in a different scenario, and it's boring now. It's getting really boring. When Ice Age used to be something, those scenes made the films. Like, in the first few films, in the first, three films, the scratch scenes were excellent. They were so funny. I liked them. in the fourth and fifth, they're just tired, you know, and this, because it's in space, you know it's bad when you have to send the franchise into space, but that's the worst of it. However, the good things are that it's a little bit better than the fourth one. It has a bit more of a pace to it. It's dumb fun, you know, the plot is dumb, but it's fun at least. Again, with the Peaches subplot, she's getting married. Really, that was very quick. She meets this guy called Julian. He's a bit of an annoying character at the best of times. Sid also gets a love interest, which is, again, unnecessary and forced, but voiced by Jessie J, surprisingly, Brooke. I mean, for a sloth, she looks damn pretty. But, I mean, there's a funny moment when they meet, but it's very forced, and this movie's a bit all over the place. You can have fun with it. I had fun, I'm not gonna lie. I actually had fun with this movie. I'm like, yeah, it was fun. I liked it, but I thought it was all right. And I don't really care for the Peaches subplot. They should really remove it. Well, I mean, if this is the last movie, then I suppose it's a nice way to tie things up. I like the characters of Ice Age, which is only the reason why I've sort of stuck with the series for as long as I have, really. I like Manny, Sid, Diego, and Scrat, and all the characters from since the first movie. But the series has descended into a silly, childlike aroma, which is a shame. And this movie is kind of silly at points, but not as silly as the fourth for me. The Shangri-Llama was kind of funny. That was cool. Again, it's a silly plot, but you can just have fun with it. Buck is also back. I like that's that's good. Sorry, let me just get rid of that. I keep getting messages all the time. It fucking annoys me. Buck returns, which is good. He's nowhere near as good as he is in Ice Age 3, but it's still nice to have him there, I suppose. It's something that gives the movie a bit of a yay, over the fourth one. I was kind of disappointed that Buck wasn't really in the fourth one. Well, he was for like 2 seconds, at the very start. But so it's nice to sort of, it's nice to see him back maybe one more time. And he's still his mad self that he was in the third movie. Yeah. But Ice Age 5, it's not really going to change the franchise in any way. If anything, it's an indication for it to stop now. I think 5 is more than enough. I think 3 was enough. But, I didn't hate it. I actually didn't hate it. I thought it was fun. It was all right. It was fun. It was dumb fun. I mean, the cast do a great job. It's really well animated. But yeah, the series does need to call it a day now. Blue Sky, just think of something else to do, please. Ugh. Okay, so number 3 is in fact a really difficult one to decide, because I think my number 3 and 2 could potentially interchange, but number 3 is going to be Ice Age 2. Yeah, I was really tempted to place this at number 2, but I don't know. I mean, Ice Age 2, The Meltdown, I think it's good. It's good. I mean, it's not a great sequel, but it's good. It has a good situation. The situation of the story is very intense, with the flood approaching them. And, it's a nice story. It's simple, but it works. They don't really push to that emotional peak like the first one, which is a shame. But still, there is merit, and there is a lot to like here. The characters are great. It's nice to have them back. And it's also very nice to see new characters such as Ellie, Crash, Eddie. They're all great. The climax of the film is quite good, with Manny trying to save Ellie from the cave. And those two sea monsters are kind of useless. They don't do anything. That's the problem with a lot of the sequels. There's no main antagonist in the films. Apart from Ice Age 4. But this movie's fun. It has a lot going for it. Some of the comedy is quite funny. some of the comedy for 4 and 5 are a little bit, is a little bit, you know, too childlike and a bit too lame. But this movie has some good comedy. I find it quite funny. The Fire King scene was quite weird. It was kind of unnecessary. I didn't get that. But the mini sloths capturing Sid and, you know, trying to sacrifice him, it just felt like a really random scene. It's a little bit sillier and more goofy than the first one, but unfortunately. But you know, again, you can have fun with it. It's a fun film, and the music is great by John Powell as well. I don't have much to say about it. It's great. If you again, if you want my further thoughts, do check out my review. So number two is gonna be Ice Age 3. As I said, I could probably swap 2 and 3 around at points, but the only reason why I've put 3 over 2 is because, quite simply, that there's more happening in the third one. I feel that there's a constant momentum to it. The second one is a lot of stopping and starting, which isn't a bad thing, but I just feel that the third one works a lot better in its favour. With the fact that there's a lot more going on. I mean, again, it doesn't reach that emotional peak that you want. I like the inclusion of Scratte, the female Scrat. She's fun. She's cool, and their little love story is quite funny. and there's the funny montage at the end when the acorn is like alone, and they play a song, which is quite funny. I love the comedy in this film. I thought Buck was hilarious. And the whole film was hilarious for me. It was just really funny. It's just a fun romp. It's the most funniest. It's the fun most funnest rompiest of the I say, and, oh, fucking messages. It's definitely credit where it's due to the directors and everyone. I mean, say what you will about timelines. The timelines are all screwed up. Like the dinosaurs being underworld. I mean, just ignore all of that and just have fun with it, because that's all it is at the end of the day. And it's very sweet when Peaches is born at the end, you know. That's very touching. But it's you know, I mean, and again, the music is great. You know, I don't think any other Ice Age movie captures the adventure feel as much as this one, even though the first one is, well, you know what I think of the first one. It's, you know, they've never captured, none of the other films have captured the adventure feel as well as this, I feel, because it's just such a rip-roaring ride. And, you know, and they go rescue Sid, and Sid learns to be a parent, and, you know, that's quite a nice storyline. And, yeah, this film is, it's great fun, I like it. So, of course, my pick for the best Ice Age movie is the original, the first movie, Ice Age. Yeah, man, Ice Age is a great movie. It's fantastically enjoyable. It tells a simple story, but it tells it with so much heart, which is what the sequels really lacked, is that, you know, that storytelling. You know, they never push for that emotional edge, and the first Ice Age movie definitely tells that. I mean, it's very symbolic for Manny, particularly Manny, who, you know, he's lost his family, he's craving another family, and this baby gives him, you know, a chance to, obviously, in this film, metaphorically, become a father figure and care. He cares for the baby, and it, you know, especially that scene when they look at the mural on the wall and they show that flashback of when his family got killed. That's powerful stuff. And, you know, it's very sad, really, see, but these films, I feel, are about Manny's journey through life and trying to reclaim what he has lost. And obviously, as the films go on, he, you know, he meets Ellie, he has a daughter, and then his daughter grows up, and, you know, it's all about Manny's journey, really, but also the other characters. I mean, Sid is hilarious in this film. I think the comedy is just absolutely brilliant. Diego's a great character too. I like how his loyalties change this film. He's very torn between his friends who he's just made, and because he cares for the baby as well, and you know his pack who he's been you know working with for a long time. You know the pack who are the only people he's ever really known. So that's really interesting. What else? The music is great. This movie's a lot of fun as well. You can have so much. You can have a lot of fun with it. I like Soto, the villain, the leader of the pack. There's a great fight towards the end, and also when Diego sacrifices himself for Manny, that's great. And that baby is cute. That baby is cute, man. Yeah, I mean, you can tell the animation's a bit dated by this point, but obviously the animation goes on to improve in the sequels. But it's clearly the best Ice Age movie. It is. It's just got everything. So, with that in mind, that's it, folks. That's my ranking of the five Ice Age movies. So, yeah, just to refresh my list, number five is Ice Age 4, Continental Drift. Number four is Ice Age 5, Collision Course. Number three is Ice Age 2, The Meltdown. Number two is Ice Age 3, Dawn of the Dinosaurs. And number one is Ice Age 1. So, thank you guys all for watching, and as always, I'm Mr. Talos 11. See ya.